आओ तुम्हें वीरता की कहानी सुनाती हूँ, दृढ़ निश्चय और संकल्प से मिलाती हूँ, कारगिल के रक्त से सनी मिट्टी के दर्द का एहसास कराती हूँ, तुम्हें कारगिल से जुड़ी एक कहानी बताती हूँ। Born on 21st June 1969, Padmapani or Bablu as he was called by everyone in his family, was the second child born to his overjoyed parents. He was a highly imaginative person and being a music enthusiast as well, he exercised interest in playing various instruments from mouth organs to drums to tabla. He was also blessed with an artistic hand, a flair for writing and was an excellent orator. His childhood was highly influenced by his mother's words on values, traditions and honor, qualities which he carried on till his final moment, leading him to a glorious end. He fit in like a hand in the glove in the army. It was his calling, he realized. This is what he was meant to do. His parents couldn't have been prouder of him. Watching him during his passing out parade as he got commissioned into the Indian Army's 2nd Rajputana Rifles on the 21st of August 1993. As years passed by, 2nd Lieutenant Acharya had rose through the ranks and was now a major in the army. All was going well until 28 June 1999 when Major Acharya was summoned to undertake the greatest task of mankind. In spite of knowing that this might be his final call, he did it with utmost dedication. As he had penned down in a letter to his father just 10 days ago, "Dear Papa, don't worry about casualties. It is a professional hazard, but it is for a great cause. Tell Mama that combat is an honor of a lifetime and I could not think of anything less. What better way to serve the nation?" It was 28 June 1999 that this brave son of the motherland, as a company commander, was assigned the task to capture the enemy bunker at Toluling Top, as it was a dominant position overlooking the Srinagar-Leh highway. The success of the battalion was hinged on the early capture of this position. The Battle of Toluling was thus one of the pivotal battles in the Kargil War. The enemy position was heavily fortified, strongly held and covered with mines, sweeping machine guns and artillery fire. Such were the adversaries, but once a task is given to a true leader, he takes up the challenge, motivates his men and leads them to success. Reaching towards the enemy position itself was a dangerous task. On a dark night, leading the troops when you get zeroed in by the artillery is the most dreadful moment of your life. When the first artillery shell falls, the men are ordered to take cover, and before taking cover, within a moment, there is a rainfall of artillery shells in every direction for you to run. For a moment, you feel like there is no escape from this. The death of you and your men is inevitable. Watching the shells falling on your men, watching splinters hitting and injuring your men, listening to the loud noises of shells mixed with the screams of men. Yes, the scream that will make you realize that you are in a situation dealing with death, where kill or get killed are the only two options. That is the moment when the company commander has to take decisions in split second, and to be very honest here, one wrong decision can lead to the death of the whole company. So, watching this and simultaneously not worrying for his personal safety, not worrying about the rain full of artillery shells, not worrying about the splinters coming out of the shells which may hit him, not worrying about his own personal life, Major Acharya, like a true leader, rose and motivated his men to take up the task of capturing the post. It seemed like he was challenging the enemy. "What are you? Even a rain full of artillery shells cannot break me. I will come up and I will complete the objective given to me." And he truly lived up to it. Reaching near the post, Major Acharya crawled up to the enemy position and lobbed grenades on them. But it didn't come without losses on his part, as in this daring assault, he too got seriously injured. Despite the heavy injuries, in spite of being unable to move, he, like a true leader, ordered his men to leave him and charge at the enemy while he too continued to fire at the enemy. The words of your commander matter the most in the battlefield, as more than reason, motivation comes from the emotions embedded in words, and Major Acharya did this with sheer depth. Within moments after this, the enemy position was overrun by a highly charged soldiers and the mission was accomplished. However, as it is rightly said, there is no victory without sacrifice. The true leader who had just one objective in his mind, to lead his men to victory, who fought and led his men without giving regard to his personal safety, succumbed to his injuries after completing the mission. It was on the same day, 28 June 1999, that his father, a retired wing commander, received a phone call. The phone call, which brings with it a bag of mixed emotions, the most prominent ones being sorrow as well as pride. Your son fought bravely. He created history, but he is no more, said the voice on the other side. We probably will never be able to imagine what went through his father's mind, but while speaking to the media later, he said, "You have to accept the inevitable and adjust accordingly. It is tough to digest, but we are proud of him. We will miss him." Not to forget that when Major Acharya made the supreme sacrifice, his wife was 6 months pregnant. Though, as is the norm in the army, the interests of your country and your countrymen always come above your personal interests. He laid down his life in spite of knowing that he has a pregnant wife waiting at home, old parents waiting for him to come so that he can be their support in their old age. He surely knew that his family needed him, but more than that, what he knew was that the moment demanded his sacrifice as the country needed him the most. Major Acharya was a true warrior who went down with utmost glory. For his gallant action, sheer dedication and exemplary leadership, he was awarded India's second highest wartime gallantry award, the Mahavir Chakra. Major Acharya, you may not be physically present between us, but you will live in our hearts forever. Jai Hind!